Hello friends, this video on some natural phenomena part 4 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now whatever we are talking about right now, we are only talking about static charges. The charges are not moving, they are like located on a particular surface or on a particular object. Now in our previous lesson we talked about current, electric current, and while we were talking about current, that time also we were talking about flow of charges. We said that when charges flow from one place to another, that constitute current. Now, how exactly is static electricity different from current electricity? Because a lot of people get confused about these two. That while talking about current also, we are talking about charges. While talking about these kind of attraction and repulsion also, we are talking about charges. So how are both of these different? Because when the balloon gets electrically charged, I mean, the charge, we do not feel any current in the balloon, but when we touch a wire through which current is flowing, we actually feel an electric shock. So let us quickly look at the difference between static electricity and current electricity. Now, when it comes to static, the word static means when something is at rest. So that is static. So when we talk about static electricity, it arises due to imbalance of charges. What do we mean by imbalance? That means when an object either has excess of charges or it has less charges. For example, whenever an object acquires additional electrons, it becomes negatively charged. Whenever an object loses out some electrons, it becomes positively charged. And whenever the positive and the negative charges are not well balanced, we say that the object is electrically charged, right? So that is in simple terms what we call as static electricity. So whenever an object is having an excess of positive or negative charge, we say that the object is carrying static electricity. When we talk about current electricity, we always talk about flow of charges. That means the charges are not at rest at one particular place, but the charges are moving from one place to another. So movement of charges is current electricity. Static electricity, the charges are static. That is, the charges are at rest. They are not moving anywhere. So when you talk about the charged balloon, which has a net negative charge, those extra electrons are just sitting on the balloons. They are not going anywhere. But when we talk about current electricity, charges flow through a conducting material. So again, we have good conductors of electricity, we also have poor conductors of electricity. So if you look at the good conductors, they allow electricity to pass through them. That is, they allow the flow of charges through them. So charges keep flowing through that conductor, whether it is a metal wire or it is a wood. So all these are good conductors. So charges keep on flowing through these objects. So charges do not accumulate on their surface. But when it comes to say the balloon, which we described in the last section, so what happens to that balloon? The charges do not flow through the balloon. Charges just remain on the balloon. So the charges are just present on the balloon. They are not going anywhere. So that is static electricity. How do we create static electricity? It is created when two surfaces, at least one has to be insulated, they contact and separate. So what is insulated? It is nothing but a poor conductor of electricity. Now, why do we need at least one poor conductor for static electricity? Because if all the objects are good conductors, then we will never have static electricity because the charges will flow through them. So the charges will not remain static. But when it is a poor conductor, that means the charges will not be able to flow through the conductor because that object will not allow the charges to flow through them. One good example of a poor conductor is a plastic. So the plastic will not allow the charges to flow through them. So what will happen to the charges? The charges, the extra charges will just remain, or they will just remain confined in one particular area, and that is how static electricity will be formed. So for static electricity, you just need two objects or two surfaces. You bring them in contact and then you take them away. Like how you saw in case of hair and the balloon. So you bring the balloon in contact with the hair, you rub them for some time and then you take them back. And then what happens? The balloon gets charged because two surfaces were brought in contact. The balloon, which was an insulator, when they got separated, they got electrically charged. So the balloon is carrying static electricity. But in case of current electricity, it is created with conductors, because those materials which do not allow charges to flow through them, obviously in those materials you will not find current electricity. So here also, metals are very good conductors of electricity, whereas plastics, they are bad conductors of electricity. So let us quickly look at this example. When you take the balloon and rub the balloon with your hair, what are you doing? You are just bringing two surfaces in contact and then separating them. And one of these is an insulator, that is the plastic. And that's how the balloon acquires charge. So the charge which is acquired, this excess of charge which came into the balloon, that is nothing but static electricity. Correct? And because of this static electricity, the balloon is able to attract the bits of paper. So that was the example of static electricity. Now let us consider the same balloon. So this balloon is what? The balloon is negatively charged. So the balloon is carrying some charge. Now you touch that same side of the balloon which acquired the negative charge with your finger. So you gently touch it with your finger. Now your skin is, let us assume that the skin is dry. Or let us assume that the skin is even wet. So you have a lot of water, and we know water is a good conductor of electricity. So what happens? You tend to feel the static current. Why that current? Because of these excess charges, they immediately start flowing through your body. And wherever the charges flow, there is current. And this current electricity, you might feel as a very, very mild shock. So you would have seen that static current which you often feel when you touch some objects which are electrically charged. So this could have been the best explanation to distinguish between static electricity and current electricity. So I hope that these two things are clear now. So when we are talking about lightning in this lesson, we are actually dealing with static electricity. So we are not going to talk about current electricity here. Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.